Would you please stand for the presentation of the colors, and following the invocation, remain standing for the pledge and for the national anthem. Would you join me in prayer? Merciful God, we come to express our appreciation for all who have served our nation in the military. This marker is a sign. It stands today and will stand for the days to come as a sign of the honor due our military. We give thanks as well for all who would keep us safe both here and abroad. And with appreciation, we commend to you all who have made this occasion possible. Amen.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
You may be seated.
Good afternoon and welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Phyllis Griskoviak and I'm president of the Broad Ripple Garden Club. On behalf of Mary Baker, who is Broad Ripple Garden Club's Blue Star Memorial Chairman, and the ladies of Broad Ripple Garden Club, I welcome you to this very special Blue Star Memorial Dedication Ceremony. Broad Ripple Garden Club has been planning and working on this project for many months, and with the cooperation of Clay Township Trustee Doug Callahan and the City of Carmel, it is with pride that today we are able to honor all military, those who have served, those who are serving, and those who will serve in the future. As the daughter of a World War II veteran, I can't tell you how proud I am that we are here today to thank you for your honor and to honor you for your service and sacrifice to our great country. I'd also like to thank and recognize Blair Clark for starting us off with America, my country, 'tis of thee. Blair, that was beautiful. Also, thank you to Reverend George Davis for that wonderful invocation. It is also appreciated that our Carmel Public Safety officers joined us to help with the Pledge of Allegiance, and the Carmel Symphony Orchestra Brass Quintet played a beautiful version of the Star Spangled Banner. Finally, we are honored to have our Carmel VFW Post 10003 join us for the presentation of colors. Mayor Brainerd was scheduled to attend today's event, but unfortunately, he had a death in the family. He sends his best wishes. I see many guests and Carmel supporters here today. Thank you so much for attending. In our audience is Jacob Harkin with Senator Mike Braun's office. And then we have Mary Eckert, Clay Township Board, Chief Jim Barlow, Carmel Chief of Police, Chief Dave Hasbush, Carmel Fire Chief, and Judge Steve Nation, retired. In our audience is the State President of the Garden Club of Indiana, Betty Leverett. Betty is also a member of Broad Ripple Garden Club. The Central District Director of the Garden Club of Indiana, Rita Hummel, is also joining us. Jill Clouser, Vice Director, Central District, is also with us today. Cynthia Wright serves on the State Board as Treasurer and Recording Secretary and is here today as well. Jane Kessler, the Garden Club of Indiana's Blue Star Memorial Chairman, is here today from Peru, Indiana. She will speak to us in a few minutes about the history of the Blue Star Memorial. We hope you will enjoy the program we have prepared for this special occasion, and please join us for refreshments inside the John W. Hensel Government Center after the dedication ceremony. As I said before, Mayor Brainerd wasn't able to attend, but we'd like to welcome Nancy Heck. She is the Director of Community Relations and Economic Development for the City of Carmel. And she will have a few words.
Thank you, and thank you all for joining us here today. As Phyllis has said, the mayor unfortunately cannot make it, but he does send his regrets. He was really looking forward to this. It's a very unique and special ceremony to have, and I know that the Broad Ripple Garden Club and working with Mary and Phyllis has been a true joy, and I want to put a shout out to Kelly Prater, who's probably sorry that I got to use the microphone to thank her, but she worked very hard from our office as well, as did Doug Callahan and his staff at the township. But to have this marker here is such an honor and such a nice thing to have in our community, and it's one more way that we can show how much we do appreciate our veterans, those who have served, those who have sacrificed their life, and those who are serving now. Thank you.
It is now my pleasure to introduce the Garden Club of Indiana's Blue Star Memorial Chairman, Jane Kessler. Jane is the Blue Star Chairman who serves on the Garden Club of Indiana's State Board. She has served in this capacity for over 2 years and is very passionate about our Blue Star markers. Please welcome Jane Kessler.
I want to thank you very much for inviting me to be part of your Blue Star dedication. I want to examine a bit of the history of the iconic Blue Star. You will see the official banner, and some of you may have seen these in windows. Yes, you have? Okay. I was surprised to see one not too long ago, and I thought, yes, they're still using the Blue Stars. This is the official banner, which was authorized by the Department of Defense for display by families who have members serving in the armed forces during any period of war or hostilities in the United States that they are engaged in. This is also called the Blue Star flag, the service flag. It was designated and patented in World War I by Army Captain Robert L. Kuessner of the 5th Ohio Infantry, who had two sons serving on the front line. It quickly became the unofficial symbol of a child in service. The color of the star is also symbolic. The blue star represents hope and pride. In 1918, President Wilson approved a suggestion made by the Women's Committee on the Council of National Defenses that the mothers who had lost a child in the service could wear a gold gilt star on their traditional black mourning band. This led to the tradition of covering the blue star with a gold star on the service flag in their windows. The gold star represented the sacrifice to the cause of liberty and freedom. During post-World War II era, it naturally turned to suitable tributes and memorials to honor the men and women of the service. Earlier memorials had been stone or bronze statues or buildings commemorating a hero or a battle, and the Garden Club women visualized a living memorial. So in 1945, the State Highway Commissioner of the State of New Jersey spoke at the National Council Convention and described a joint venture of Garden Clubs of New Jersey and the State Highway Department, where 5 miles of highway had been designated as a memorial by the legislature and was planted with flowering dogwood trees. This was called the Blue Star Drive in honor of those who had served in World War II. So it was for the veterans. In 1946, it was adopted as a national council project, and the project proposed a ribbon of blue living memorial plants traversing every state to be called the Blue Star Memorial Highway. Using this, they created the iconic blue star, which you will see in the middle when this is unveiled. That was on the Blue Star flag as a tribute to those who had served defending the United States in World War II. In 1951, the memorial plaque was extended to include all men and women who served, were serving, or would serve in the armed forces of the United States. So that's the change. It's not just for veterans. It's for those who are serving or will serve. Realizing the need for the extension, the Blue Star Memorial Program accommodated dedicated highways such as parks, civic centers, just as we are putting it in historic grounds, and that became a part of the National Council in the 1981 convention. Garden Club members can be proud of these markers and are reminded, and this is for your Garden Club, of the fitness and the stature of an organization having embraced this method of honoring the members of our armed forces. So you have a minute to be very, very proud. I congratulate you, Broad Ripple, on your Blue Star Memorial. It now joins this ribbon dedicating the Blue Star Memorials throughout the United States. I would like to introduce Betty Leverett. She's the president of the Garden Club of Indiana. Please join me.
Good afternoon. I'm Betty Leverett, president of the Garden Club of Indiana, which represents so many, many garden clubs across the state. And I'm very proud to work with them and serve with them. Thank you for this opportunity to be a part of this special Blue Star Memorial dedication. I am pleased to represent the Garden Club of Indiana. Indiana has been a part of the Blue Star Memorials since its first marker, placed in 1950, when the National Garden Clubs established using the marker as a tribute to show remembrance to all those who have served, are serving, or will serve in our armed forces. Broad Ripple Garden Clubs setting the marker and dedicating it for the John W. Hensel Government Center is the 60th marker to be dedicated in the state of Indiana. Quite an accomplishment. I want to especially thank the club members who have worked diligently to raise the money for the marker, complete that paperwork, and organize the dedication. And being a member of this garden club, I am especially proud, and I can attest to the hard work and the many, many hours they put in. I also want to thank the Government Center, the City of Carmel, and all local entities for their tremendous support of this project. Congratulations to Broad Ripple Garden Club on joining the National Garden Clubs and the Garden Club of Indiana by adding the John W. Hensel Government Center's Blue Star Memorial marker to the ribbon of Blue Star Memorials throughout the United States. Thank you.
A poem by Kelly Strong, Freedom Is Not Free. I watched a flag pass by one day. It fluttered in the breeze. A young Marine saluted it, and then he stood at ease. I looked at him in uniform, so young, so tall, so proud. He'd stand out in any crowd. I thought how many men like him had fallen through the years, how many died on foreign soil, how many mothers' tears, how many pilots' planes shot down, how many died at sea, how many foxholes were soldiers' graves. No, freedom isn't free. I heard a sound of taps one day when everything was still. I listened to the bugler play and felt a sudden chill. I wondered just how many times that taps had meant amen, when a flag had draped a coffin of a brother or a friend. I thought of all the children, of the mothers and the wives, of fathers, sons, and husbands with interrupted lives. I thought about a graveyard at the bottom of the sea, of unmarked graves in Arlington. No, freedom isn't free.
Thank you, Tim. That was really lovely. I'm Mary Baker. I'm chairman of this project for the Broad Ripple Garden Club. And beside me, I have Doug Callahan, who's trustee.
Clay Township.
Clay Township, thank you.
That's Hamilton County, too.
Okay, Hamilton County.
Many of them.
And we have Phyllis with us, the president. All right. That poem was written by Kelly Major Strong. It's a great reminder of what our veterans mean to us and our freedom. As gardeners, we love the earth and we appreciate it. And as Americans, we love our veterans and we appreciate you. Thank you.
I want to first thank everyone for coming out on such a wonderful day, but I know where you need to hang out is under the trees, right? I noticed chairs were going back and back and back. But on behalf of the City of Carmel and Clay Township, I would like to thank the Broad Ripple Garden Club on their donation of the Blue Star Memorial Marker. This military is so special to us in the city that we are very proud to show our appreciation. At this time, I would like to ask that we take a moment of silence. Have our great God, Cal, Mary, and Phyllis up here. They're going to place that at the site of the marker. And this take about a few seconds to remember. Thank you. Before we move on, I want to recognize Donna Shively, Senator or representative from the state of Indiana. Thank you, Donna, for showing up. Now, the CSO now will play a tribute to the armed services. When your military branch is played, please stand. If you're already standing back there, jump up and down, okay?
Thank you.
Okay, I need everybody to jump in here. We're going to do a 10 count, and then they're going to pull the covering off. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
God, continue to bless America. Ladies, gentlemen, veterans, we are here to honor all veterans, and we ask that God protect those that are currently serving and those who are about to serve. We ask him to continue to take care of those veterans, especially those that are at his right-hand side looking down on us. We bow our heads and ask God's mercy, and God bless America. Thank you.
That concludes our memorial service here. We welcome everybody into the community room of the government center for cookies, cupcakes, water, lemonade, and anything else you can find. Thank you guys all for coming. We appreciate it.